chair has notice of a question of privilege from the Honorable Minister of Public Safety.
Mr. Speaker, I rise on a question of privilege to bring to your attention activities which I believe to be a contempt of this House. On Tuesday, February 14th, I introduced a Bill C-30. In the days that followed, I received a great deal of communication from Canadians in regard to this legislation. These range from the personally supportive to the critical, indeed to the humorous, but a handful were deeply threatening. It is with those in this last category that I take exception and rise in this House to seek the termination of my rights as a parliamentarian. First, Mr. Speaker, on Friday, February the 17th, I indicated by letter to your office that news reports revealed that the WikiLeaks 30 account on Twitter had connections to the House of Commons IT system. The fact that House of Commons resources appear to have been used in an attempt to anonymously degrade my reputation and obstruct me from carrying out my duties as a member of Parliament is, I contend, to be a contempt of the House. I take no issue with an open attack on the floor of this House in which the source of the attack may be seen by all. I take strong issue with the idea that House resources would be used to attack secretly a member of the House. I will await the results of your investigation into that matter, and I reserve the right to make supplementary or new arguments should that be appropriate in view of the finding. Secondly, videos posted on the internet on February 18th, on the 22nd and the 25th published various allegations about my private life, but also made specific threats, all of which was clearly stated to be in reaction to my sponsorship of proposed legislation tabled in this House, namely Bill C-30. Mr. Speaker, I will continue to do my duty and carry out my responsibilities in respect of this piece of legislation, including seeing a motion moved to refer the bill to committee where it can be discussed and debated in an open forum. Nevertheless, the actions and threatened actions contained in these videos constitute an attempt by the creators of the videos to intimidate me with respect to proceedings in Parliament. The fact that these videos contain threats and have attempted to intimidate me in my role as Member of Parliament for Provence is, I contend, a contempt of the House. Thirdly, I would like to address the fact that there is a campaign to inundate my office with calls, emails, and faxes. This campaign is hindering my staff from serving the people of Provence, and I contend is a contempt of the House. Individuals who have real and legitimate needs have been unable to contact their Member of Parliament in a timely fashion. Mr. Speaker, as you know, speakers have consistently upheld the right of members to serve constituents free from intimidation, obstruction, and interference. Speaker Lamoureux stated in a 1973 ruling that he had no hesitation in reaffirming the principle that parliamentary privilege includes the right of a member to discharge his responsibilities as a member of the House free from threats or attempts at intimidation. Mr. Speaker, it is important that we engage in debate in this House. Sometimes that debate may be vigorous, including heated rhetoric. I have served as an elected official since 1995, and in that time I've been called many things. And while occasionally distasteful, I have accepted it as part of my job. However, the online attacks launched on both myself and my family have crossed the line. Mr. Speaker, attacks on the personal life of a Member of Parliament, while not appropriate, can be judged by the public where there is public accountability. Mr. Speaker, this should concern all parliamentarians. Members of Parliament must have the freedom and ability to effectively represent our constituents in the House. I understand that the Honourable Government House Leader or the Deputy House Leader will be making further, more detailed submissions in support of this question of privilege. Should you find that there is a prima-facie question of privilege here, Mr. Speaker, I would be prepared to move the appropriate motion. Thank you.
On the same point, the Honourable Member for Toronto Centre.
Mr. Speaker, I had intended to rise today at my place on a point of privilege. With respect to the use of House of Commons computers in the matter which has been raised today by the Minister of Public Safety. I was advised yesterday that an employee of the Liberal Research Bureau, in fact, is responsible for the WikiLeaks 30 site that the minister has referred to. I discussed the matter with that individual this morning. He offered his resignation, and I've accepted his resignation. And I want to offer to the minister my personal apology to him for the conduct of a member of my staff. Mr. Speaker, I don't share many things with the Minister of Public Safety all the time, but one thing I do share with him is a sense of longevity. And I want to say to him that one of the things that I think drives all of us from makes public life difficult is when political attacks become personal. I have tried, and not always succeeded, but I've tried in my political life to make it very clear that matters of personal and private conduct are not to be the subject of political attack or political reference. I want to say very clearly that we did not meet that standard with respect to the establishment of that site by a member of the Liberal Research Bureau. And I want to apologize unreservedly to the minister for that particular incident and for that particular issue. I won't comment further with respect to the minister's point of privilege. I think some of it is justified. I think some of it is a little more problematic, but that's a view that perhaps others who are a little less directly involved in this issue will be able to comment. Je veux dire, Monsieur le Président.
I want to say, Mr. Speaker, very clearly, that I offer my apologies and those of my party for the fact that this member of our research bureau, who was responsible for the setting up of the Twitter site that dealt with the minister's personal life. I've said it in English, I'll say it again in French. For 30 years, I've been in public life, and I've always tried to make a distinction between personal activities and private activities from all of those that are in the public domain and are public activities. And frankly, something that I tried to do in my public life was not respected by a member of our group. So I can assure the minister that he has all of my apologies and excuses for this. And of course, Mr. Speaker, there are others who will have things to say about the point of privilege that the minister has raised. But once again, I offer the fact that there are points in his position that I respect and other points that I'm not entirely in agreement with, but it is the decision of the speaker that is important here. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
On the same point? I'll go to the member for Windsor Tecumseh.
Well, Mr. Speaker, it's difficult for us to get on our feet at this point and be at all sympathetic to some of the requests from the Minister of Public Safety and National Security. On the other hand, clearly, the WikiLeaks type of an approach, that type of politics, is totally offensive to this side of the House and to my political party. And I want to be on the record of saying that to the Minister. However, Mr. Speaker, I also have to raise, on the 10th of February, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, outside of the government, stood in this House and accused my party, repeatedly, unequivocally, using very offensive terminology, terms like sleazy practices, things like that, of exactly what we've now heard came from a staffer from the Liberal Party. We had nothing to do with that. And so I think on this point of privilege that I have to raise for my party is that we have to demand, and I have to ask you to compel the Minister of Foreign Affairs to come back into this House at some point as the earliest opportunity and apologize to my party and the members of my caucus.
Yeah. the Honourable Member in custody.
I rise in response to comments just made by the House Leader for the Opposition, and in setting out the terms of what the Foreign Affairs Minister said on Friday, last Friday that we were sitting. In fact, I added that on a point of order afterwards. Of course, the reliance was on media reports that had indicated through their research that the source was obviously from the NDP or someone within the NDP in the House of Commons. Obviously, that information was incorrect. Based on the information today, I have every confidence that the Minister of Foreign Affairs will give his most fulsome and complete apology and withdrawal of those remarks from Friday. Lastly, we're sitting, I certainly can do the same on behalf of our government and accept, I will leave it to the Minister himself to deal with the apology that has been offered by the member for Toronto Centre on behalf of the Liberal Party and taking responsibility for the actions in this case. But I can assure you that on behalf of the government, we withdraw those remarks, and I'm sure that the Minister of Foreign Affairs will be prepared to do the same.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I would like to take a moment as a member of the Bloc Québécois and also as the Dean of this House to say to what degree we also were shocked by the intrusion into the minister's life. I think it's one of the worst attacks I've seen in the 27 years that I have been in this House and I did see that. So I agree with the minister. We disagree entirely with the fact that some people mix public and private life, and I'll conclude by saying that I admire the leader of the Liberal Party for the honest, transparent, and very correct statement he has made here a few moments ago today. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Minister of Public Safety.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, and I thank the members in the House for the comments that they have made. I accept the personal apology of the member from Toronto Centre. I think it is a heartfelt apology and is worthy of acceptance. I would point out, though, Mr. Speaker, and this is something I will have to take under advisement, there were members of the Liberal Party who actively encouraged the use of the WikiLeaks or WikiLeaks 30 website and continuously promoted the use of that website. And I think, Mr. Speaker, you have to look into that aspect. So while I'm prepared to take the member's comments at face value that he had nothing to do with it, I think the evidence is clear on the public record that there were at least one member who advocated on a continuous basis the use of that, and you, I would respectfully submit, need to take a look at that. Thank you.
Minister of Foreign Affairs.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. I saw the interventions by my friend from Windsor, Tecumseh, and the government House Leader. At times, Mr. Speaker, emotions get strained in this House. I think they get to particular strain when you have a friend and a colleague who is under attack, and when you sometimes rush to judgment believing certain media reports. I heard the comments by the opposition House Leader, and I want to unequivocally and unconditionally apologize and retract my comments to him and to anyone in the Democratic Party who may have taken offense. I think I went out of my way to point out, I went out of my way not to single anyone out, but I unconditionally retract those comments and unconditionally apologize to he, his caucus, and the members of the party who were offended.
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary of the Government House Leader. What's that? The Minister of Foreign Affairs?
I'd also like to retract the comments I made with the Liberal Party on Friday last as well.
In which I said I wasn't accusing them of anything.